Hello, this is Ralph, and I am doing a Rider-Waite tarot deck review. This is a side-by-side comparison. I'm going to compare the Rider-Waite tarot to the Rider-Waite tarot and the Rider-Waite tarot. Now, what am I talking about? Well, there are three different styles of Rider-Waite decks that I have. I've got the standard, which we see right here, the standard size. They also make a miniature size, and there is the Rider-Waite miniature. Same card, Page of Swords. The detail is pretty much the same. It's kind of hard to tell because it's so small, but I mean it's a pretty nice rendition of the standard size deck, just in a miniature form. And to give you an idea, a little better idea of how small this really is, I'm going to put down a quarter right there. Standard United States quarter. And another one. And another one. And we see that the mini deck is just about 3/4 tall. And it comes in pretty handy. Now, I don't use the miniature deck for reading. You can. I don't like the small size. It's kind of difficult for me to get my hands around. But what I love to do with the miniature deck is to use it on charts. I create flow charts, study charts, charts where I just kind of study the numerological attributions and meanings of the cards, and you can organize charts according to the planetary attributions and elemental attributions and things like that. And if you have like a magnetic whiteboard and a few strong magnets, you know, you can put these cards up on that magnetic whiteboard without defacing the cards much at all, and just organize them any way that you see fit and use that board for study. Other people use the mini deck for putting in their journals. They'll do tarot journaling, and then they'll paste the card right in there on the tarot journal. Now, my wife has smaller hands than I do, and she actually does use the miniature deck for readings, and they're the perfect size that if you're traveling around and you don't want to be caught unexpectedly without a pack of tarot cards, you can take that miniature deck and fit it comfortably in your purse or in your glove compartment of your car, and it's a very, very portable deck, so that makes it handy. But for me, for average readings, standard readings, I prefer the regular standard size. Now, if you think bigger is better, they also make a giant size Rider-Waite. Let's make sure I'm getting that in the camera. Yeah, there we go. And yes, this is quite a bit taller. Now, here's my hand for comparison. Get my hand right over the card. Now, obviously, I think, perhaps not so obviously, this deck, the giant size, is too big, in my opinion, for doing readings too. But what I love about the giant size card is if you're teaching video classes, video courses, or teaching students tarot face-to-face, it's neat to have the large card so your students can clearly see the details. Now, I'm just going to center this little bugger here. Actually, this big bugger here. So, we can get a little better look at it. And let's take away the mini, too. And now, yeah, I think you can see where you can see everything really nicely without really zooming in the camera that much. And you can point out the details that you want your students to see, and just focus on those details. Now, what I also like the giant size card for is if you do ritual and you incorporate tarot cards in your rituals or magical workings, and you're doing public or, you know, group ritual or group ceremony. The giant size card is helpful so that not only you can see what you're talking about and what you're doing with the card, the other people in your group can also see what you're doing. So the giant size for teaching or for public ritual or group ritual, group magical workings is handy as can be. And so there we have it. We've got the standard size Rider-Waite, which we can see there. We also got the giant and the miniature edition. And of course, there's a lot more decks, other varieties of the Rider-Waite deck that you can get, but those are the two ones I'm going to focus on right now for this video. So until later, y'all take care and just keep that tarot flame burning bright. I'll catch you in the next video.